Good morning, everyone. Chodesh Tov and Shana Tova. Today is the first day of the first month of the year, Rosh Chodesh Nisan. But as we read in the Torah portion yesterday, Rosh Chodesh Nisan is the first month of the entire year. So today is literally the head of the year, Rosh Hashanah. The Jewish calendar is very different than the Gregorian calendar. The first obvious difference is that the Gregorian calendar follows the solar cycle. And of course, the Jewish calendar follows the lunar cycle of the month. Every Rosh Chodesh is the rebirth of the new moon. However, there's another fascinating difference between the secular and the Jewish calendar. In the secular calendar, there's one new year, January 1st. But on the Jewish calendar, there's actually two new years. There is Rosh Hashanah at the first day of the month of Tishrei, which we celebrated exactly 6 months ago. And then there's today, the first month on the biblical calendar. Now, why do we have two separate new years, 6 months apart on the Jewish calendar? And the answer is very simple. We are all made up of a body and a soul. Our body is a vessel for our soul. So too, the world has a body and a soul. The body is the physical creation. The soul is the purpose and the intent of creation. You know, human beings are superior to any other form of creation. So if you take a plant, in order for a plant to be happy, what does it need? It needs light, it needs sunshine, it needs water, it needs air, and it's a very happy, successful plant. But an animal, in order to be free and happy, cannot have those same ingredients. It needs to be mobile, to be able to move around. If an animal was rooted in one place, it would be miserable. But if an animal has the freedom to roam the earth and it has food and air and water and sunlight, it's a very happy animal. But an animal doesn't have intellect, doesn't have a spiritual purpose in its creation. Human beings have a mind and a heart and a soul which has to have a higher focus and purpose and pleasure and meaning to its existence. And therefore, if a human being has all of its physical needs met, it has water, it has sunshine, it has air, it has even freedom to be mobile, but it doesn't have a consciousness, a meaning and a purpose to live every day, then it will be unhappy, frustrated, and miserable. And so God created the physical world on the first day of Tishrei, which we celebrate on New Year, which is the creation of Adam and Eve, mankind. But today we come to the higher purpose, Rosh Chodesh Nisan. And from today, we begin to focus on our spiritual purpose of creation. And that's why in the Haggadah, it actually says, Yachol Me Rosh Chodesh. You would think that you should start telling the story of the Exodus from Egypt, not on the night of Passover in 2 weeks from now, but from today, Rosh Chodesh. Why would you think so? Because today is the day we were given our Jewish purpose and identity. And indeed, if you go back to the very first verse in the Torah, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Rashi quotes a rabbi, Rabbi Yitzchak, who says, why did the Torah begin with, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth? It should have began with the verse we read yesterday about today. Today is the first day of the new month of the year. Why would Rabbi Yitzchak ask that question? Because Rabbi Yitzchak's saying is what's important to us is not that God created the physical matter. What's important to us is that God gave us a soul with a spiritual purpose and focus to our lives. The inner consciousness of man is what we need to focus on to find our true happiness and fulfillment in life. And so today is a very significant day. Today is the day we as a Jewish people receive our mandate, our marching orders, our mission statement to live as a sacred and a holy nation. And so I wish everyone a Chodesh Tov, not just a good month, but a good year ahead. And today is the day we begin to focus on the fact that in this day, God began to prepare to take the Jews out of Egypt to give us our personal redemption. And redemption doesn't just mean from physical slavery and the shackles of confinement physically, but also the spiritual confinement that the soul finds itself confined in the body. We are all going out of Egypt constantly. The word Mitzrayim Egypt also means Meitzarim, narrowness and confinedness. The struggle we all feel as human beings is the tension between the body and the soul. The more we liberate our soul and free our soul and allow our soul to shine forth and serve its purpose in this world, the more freedom we have, the more liberation we have, the happier and the more fulfilled we are. Because as human beings, if we don't have a deeper, more meaningful spiritual focus and consciousness, then we are not living to our maximum and fullest capacity. On Friday in Israel, there was a terrible tragedy. A 38-year-old man was hit by a bus as he was driving his bicycle in northern Galilee in upper Israel. And the tragedy is that this man passed away so young, but this man was an incredible human being. His name was Roi Sadan, and he was known as the ambassador on wheels. In 2007, Roi Sadan went on a bicycle ride. He was a professional cyclist, and he had a bicycle that he called Emunah, faith. And in the back of his bicycle, he had a flag of the State of Israel, blue and white, fluttering in the background. And he went on a trip literally around the world, which spanned six continents. He went from Africa, South America, China, Russia, Afghanistan. He literally traveled for 5 years by bicycle, and he traveled the globe over 41,000 miles. And wherever he went, he spoke in schools, he spoke in Jewish communities to talk about Israel and to talk about the beauty of the Jewish people in the land of Israel. And as he said in his own words, "I am an unofficial ambassador of Israel on wheels to go tell the world the truth about Israel so they shouldn't believe how Israel is portrayed falsely in the media." And this extraordinary cyclist tragically was just riding his bike near his home in northern Israel, struck by a bus and passed away this Friday. Roi Sadan's legacy lives on, and his message lives on, and his message is that we Jews especially must remember that we are all ambassadors of God on this earth. We are an Am Kadosh. We are a nation that was given a sacred mission, and our mission is to be an Or LaGoyim, a light unto the nations, to be ambassadors, whether we do it with our bicycles, or we do it with our legs, or we do it with our speech, whichever way we can, wherever we go, we have to shed and spread the light of Torah and the beauty and the goodness and the righteousness and the morality and the ethics and the principles and the values of Judaism. That is what today, the first day of the Jewish calendar, teaches us, that we were put here for a higher purpose and a higher meaning. And only by embracing that higher purpose and meaning can we find the true freedom and liberation that this month of Nisan signifies. So Chodesh Tov, a good month, Shavuot Tov, a good week, and Shana Tova, a good, happy Jewish New Year. Have a wonderful day.